lines are drawn early. But on his way to these ordered categories, he will find a no man's land called teenage. Perhaps he will become a mod. Mod is a generic term for the modern young man. He rides a motor scooter, likes brightly colored clothes, and tolerates mod girls as an accessory. He doesn't know that the emergence of the peacock trend in male dress was forecast by sociologists after the end of World War II. Sociologists saw that in the 60s, there'd be more eligible boys than girls for the first time in many centuries. Clothes would be brighter. And to meet this demand, the male boutique made its appearance in London. At first laughed at, they are now firmly established trendsetters among the mod teenage boys. The colored trousers, the scarlet jacket, none of this would have been conceivable 15 years ago on a man. The clothes are distinctive. They are his identifying uniform. They proclaim his assertion and his acceptance of the group mold. The rockers are another teenage category. They deride the mod's dress display, but they peacock in their own way just as frantically. Metal studs in leather jackets, the leather wear itself, the jack boots, these are just as much a proclamation of group identity. To discover their philosophy, we shall return to them later. Another group is the Beatniks. Their name has something of defeat in it. They pride themselves in their non-conformity, but their very revolt serves to emphasize the norms against which they proclaim their rejection.
Now John Henry, he was a little baby. He was sitting on his pep, isn't he? Lord, he gave out a long and lonesome cry. Said, this hammer gonna be the death of me, not long. This hammer gonna be the death of me. John Henry was working on the railroad. His hammer was striking fire. So tall, John Henry was so small. Lord, he laid down his hammer. Lord, he died, yeah, yeah. He laid down his hammer and he died. Now some say he's from Texas, and some say he's from France, but I know he's just a Louisiana boy who died with a hammer in his hand, Lord, Lord. Died with a hammer in his hand. Yeah, blues man.
What's your name?
Michael.
How old are you, Michael?
20.
Do you work, Michael?
No.
What do you do?
I write poetry.
You write poetry?
Yeah.
Is this your aim in life, to write poetry?
Yeah, it is.
Had anything published?
No, not as yet, no.
Can you quote me a stanza from a poetry?
Well, the only one I can remember offhand is one of my early ones, and it's, I turned right into heaven and saw that pothead Peter polishing the keys to the pan. That's all I can remember of it.
Tell me, I'm intrigued. That key in your ear, what's that for?
Well, it's purely for decoration. It's my nickname, you know.
What's your nickname again?
Jailer.
Jailer. Tell me one thing, Michael.
Yeah.
You believe in free love?
Yeah.
Where were you educated?
Berkhamsted Public School, Northwestern Polytechnic, and in my bedroom.
In your bedroom? I see.
Many of them.
Do you believe in marriage?
If people love each other, they are married.
I see. How about you, David?
I believe in it. Choice of the two people as individuals as well as together.
You mean if you like one another, you live together?
Yes, I think one should live together for a certain time beforehand, though.
What do you think about that?
I don't believe in marriage at all.
You don't believe in marriage at all? Would you live with a girl if you like her?
Certainly.
How about children? Would you have children?
I believe there ought to be some form of contract written for children in the case of children.
I got my brain on you. I got my brain on you.
Sally?
16.
16, where do you work? Or what do you do?
Well, I work at Waterloo and I'm working in an office.
I see. Would you say you're a beatnik?
No.
You're not. Susie, how old are you?
17.
17, what do you do?
I I'm short and typist.
Are you a beatnik?
No.
No. Why do you come here?
So I've got a lot of friends here.
Boyfriends or girlfriends?
Both.
Girlfriends and boyfriends?
Yeah.
Would you like to marry a beatnik?
I don't know.
How about you? Would you like to marry a beatnik?
No, I wouldn't.
You wouldn't?
Well, you can go to the east, go to the west. I don't care where you go, baby, as long as you come back. I got my brand on you. I got my brand on you. Oh, yeah. Well, there's nothing you can do, love. I got my brand on you.
What's your name?
Larry.
Would you like to say a few words?
A few words.
A few words. Very good. Very good, lad. Yeah. Tell me, what do you do for a living?
Nothing.
Nothing at all? How do you live?
I don't know.
Who
exists.
Support you?
My dad.
My dad. Good dad. What's your name, dear?
Anne.
Do you know Larry?
Yes.
Are you his girlfriend?
No, we're very intimate, though.
You're very intimate?
Yes.
Together, that is?
Yes, together.
Very good. Tell me, what do you think about beatniks?
I think they're great.
You think they're great? You believe in... Well, tell me, what is a beatnik?
A great knit. A great knit, yeah.
You're a great knit?
No, I'm not a beatnik.
Well, you just told me beatniks are great knits.
I'm not a beatnik.
You're not a beatnik?
No.
Anne, are you a beatnik?
No.
Larry, surely you are.
I'm a tramp.
You're just a plain...
He's a bum.
He's a bum?
Yes.
You're sure?
How much did that camera work?
That camera? £200 or £300.
For flogging it.
Flogging it? Well, we're pulling it now and again.
Where are your uncles down the road?
Uncles down the road. Well done. What's your definition of a beatnik?
Well, I don't like the word myself, because if you ask the average person in the street what a beatnik is, they'll immediately turn around and say a person who doesn't wash, doesn't work, just got long, filthy hair and is a parasite on society.
And you think this is entirely wrong?
Yes, it is entirely wrong.
Entirely wrong. Thank you very much. You've been playing together long, Ray?
Yeah, about 2 years, man, you know.
2 years?
Yeah.
What's your ambition, Ray?
Be the top harmonica player in this country, where I've always wanted to be, you know.
Wonderful. Tell me, I mean, what do you do in the summer?
Well, we go down the south of France, usually Cairns, and busk, you know, around the cafes and that, make a few bob. It's pretty good.
How do you get down there?
Oh, we go by train, it costs £12.10 from London to Cairns, you know.
I see, sounds like an advert for British Railways.
Oh, it's all right.
I see, and, you know, in England, what do you do?
Well, we folk singing, you know, we go busking and down the stations and a few folk clubs, that kind of thing,
Well, which station? Main line?
Yeah, no, Piccadilly Circus Underground Station, usually.
Piccadilly Circus?
Saturday night.
And how do you get on?
£8 a night.
Got a girlfriend?
Me? No, man, you know, I just get them when I can, you know. But no, I'm not living at home at the moment now, I'm living down at Brompton Road, you know, just off the old Brompton Road.
Do you believe
in
marriage?
Well, let's say I can't really say now, you know, so I don't really know, you know.
I see. But you'll give it a miss for a while, anyway.
Yeah.
There are others, belonging to no group, because they are unaware of themselves as members of any society. They dissipate their identity in complete passivity. They become reduced to human adjuncts of a machine, and the machine's flashing lights lends an air of action, of doing something, a sedative to cover an attitude of cynical indifference.